Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of From the Field Q&A with P&J. I'm Pedro.
And I'm John. Let's dive into some questions we've received this week from the community. Pedro, how about you start with the first one this week?
All right. So first question, is there a way to rename a collection?
There is a way to rename a collection. There's going to be some other things you need to update, some tables here shown on the screen. But you could also try exporting the collection, renaming it, and then re-importing it. That might be a little bit easier if you're technical like that. So there are a couple ways to do it, yes. All right, so the next question is, are network vulnerability scans performed against the network and systems?
Yeah, all communication happens over HTTPS, currently using TLS 1.3, and all communication between internal services within Directus cloud infrastructure happens in a private subnetwork with a need to know access control policy.
Yeah, so we're constantly monitoring for vulnerability scans and making sure that it's a very secure network. We're definitely security first here at Directus.
Huge priority, yep. Okay, next question. Is there a way to have a user-friendly display name for specific content type?
Yes, actually in the backend controls, as you can see here in this screen recording that I did earlier today, if you navigate to the table and item, just click in field and then you can add a field name translation, which will display it how you would like to display it. So it looks the way that you want it to look and not a technical name.
Rad.
But very good question. Hopefully that screen share helped. And then on to, I think the last question this week. Pedro, how much control do I have over roles and permissions? Can I configure what certain users see versus what the public sees?
Yeah, actually, this is a big reason a lot of people come to Directus. We have a lot of really great and granular control. We actually just released a great YouTube video with a really high-level explanation on this. But you can create as many users as you want, and they start off as default deny, and then you can enable what you want them to have access to, essentially, all the way down to the current, you know, field and row level, with the ability to do user variables like $ current underscore user.
Yeah, very granular. You can obviously allow full controls for certain users and roles, but you can get very granular, which people do. So great question.
Yeah. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe to the video. And don't forget to hop into one of our communities, whether it's Discord or GitHub, to follow along and ask questions. We'll see you next time.
Bye, y'all.